What's up, guys? Welcome back to the Cheesy Does a Cooking Vlog. Happy quarantine day number 14. Today we're gonna make breakfast burritos, but it's also my birthday today, so against all rules and regulations, I'm gonna invite the boys over for a little party. Boys, say hello.
Hi. Hi.
The version we're gonna make is the California style breakfast burrito because we're actually in California. Fun fact, I'm from Arizona, so if we were in Arizona, I wouldn't be making a burrito at all, in fear of the INS getting a whiff of anything Mexican. My recipe includes a few simple ingredients. Steak, eggs, cheese, potatoes,
free shavacadoo,
and whatever is in the fridge that's expiring soon. Let's start with the steak. This is actually a ribeye, but we want to use flat iron for this. We're gonna sous vide this. I've done sous vide a few times before, so I won't go too much into detail. Basically, you add steak, thyme, and crush garlic into a cryovac bag and suck the air out of it with a vacuum sealer. I have none of that foo-foo ass kitchen gear, so I stole this colostomy bag, which I pried from my grandpa's cold, lifeless fingers. Make sure the bag is airtight. If you place it in hot water, it'll help push the air out and you can seal it. Or you can put your pee-pee kissers on there and suck it out. Let it simmer for about 30 minutes at 120 degrees. I'm in the bathroom. Next, we're gonna chop up some veggies. Start with onions. And make sure you do this in front of a date, so when you're tearing up, she thinks that you have a sensitive side. Now some potatoes that we'll mentally slice and dice. Then cut up some cheves. I'm using a knife this time because I read a comment that said the reason I do all these gimmicky chops is because I don't know how to properly use a kitchen knife. Well, joke's on you, dummy. Next, we're prepping our eggs. Notice I have both regular eggs and organic brown eggs. If you're watching this video significantly after the posting date, you should Google grocery stores in March 2020 and realize how much of a flex this is. Sometimes you have to punch an old lady in the face to get the last case of eggs. Some call it assault, but I call it Darwinism. In a hot nonstick fry pan, start by cooking your potato cubelets because they take a while. You want to cook them in some oil until they're golden brown, like this. At this point, you can add your onions to the taters. Then shake it like a newborn baby until it starts looking translucent. Now we need some breakfast sausages. And no, I'm not talking about Brad from Bumble. I'm talking about juicy pork garbage. Pew, pew, pew. Pew. The reason why we call it pork garbage is because in Arizona, after we butcher the pig, the scraps that were supposed to go into the garbage go into the sausage maker. Then, whatever's left in the sausage maker goes down into the basement to feed our sweatshop children. Yeezys are expensive. Now, let's switch gears to cooking the steak that's been sous videing. Season the steak well with salt and pepper. My camera died as I threw the carcass in the pan, so I'm sorry I denied you of that sizzle point. Send me your Hotmail account and I'll send nudes. Cook each side until you develop a nice crust. Don't leave it in too long. Remember, it's 120 degrees inside. The cook will bring it to a perfect medium rare at 130 to 135-ish. Now you want to slice it. Make sure you slice against the grain so that the meat pulls apart easily, like the last woman I loved. It's tearing up my heart, man. Okay, last thing is cooking the eggs. Scramble the eggs together and add some cheez and salt. By the way, I used the same pan and never cleaned it once through this whole process. Fight me. It's burrito building time. First things first, cheese layer number one. I'm using a Mexican blend from Trader Jose's. I prefer Monterey Jack, but Trump said that cultural appropriation is A-OK. Then, eggs for the burrito, eggs for me, and more eggs for the burrito. Next is a sausage meat log, steak bits, cheese layer numero dos, flaming taters and onions, and because we're in California,
free shavacadoo!
And lastly, tres quesos. Okay, now the terrifying task of rolling this all together. Is it too late for me to tell you to microwave this tortilla for 20 seconds before you stuffed anything into it? It will make it much easier to mold. However, I am not a fearful people. Just think of this like a corset, and you're just stuffing a bunch of shit into a compartment that can barely handle the cargo. I mean, look what it's done for Kim. Okay, very last step is to grill this baby on both sides. This will melt the cheese and lock all that gooch together. And there you have it, guys, a quarantino breakfast burrito. It's cheesy, it's meaty, it's eggy, and it's breakfasty. However, it is 11 at night, but who cares? I haven't spoken to a human person in 14 days, and I'm drunk.
That's it for today, guys. Make sure you look at this. Follow me everywhere at Cheez Does Cooking. I don't really have an outro, because honestly, who gives a fuck? Nobody watches the outros anyway. And my neighbors are having sex again. At least somebody gets to.
Oh. Oh, I know that move.